Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for joining in with us this morning. We'd love for you to go ahead and drop a comment below, let us know that you're watching, and share this link on Facebook so that more people can join in with us this morning. We're just going to take a couple of minutes and go through some announcements for the church.
You want me to go now?
Go
okay.
<Fred.
laughs> All right. So the first one that's actually starting today that we want to make you aware of is the launching of our life groups. Britt has been working hard on that with some of our leaders, some of the people that's going to be leading that. And we want to encourage you to be a part of that. We've got three different options because we know that this time is still kind of weird for us. We want to limit ourselves in some way, but we don't want that to stop you from being connected into a life group. So we have three different options. You can go with an in-person life group. You can do a strictly online life group, or we do have an option of doing a hybrid. If you're interested in any of those three, which I hope you are, go and fill some information out on this address you see on your screen, or call us, email us, whatever you want to do. We want to encourage you to be a part of that.
And the youth are meeting again tonight at 6 p.m. and we're going to be in the downstairs area, which will be a new space for us, and we're excited to do that. We're going to have some fun and games, and we're starting our new series, which is titled Stronger. We're looking at sort of pain and hurt and how we can come alongside one another and help each other grow in that, and more importantly, to see how God can help us through those situations. And the kids are also starting a new series called Wise, when they're looking into the life of Solomon, the wisest man known in the Bible.
Yes.
So it'll be a cool series as well.
Just want to mention Celebrate Recovery. The first Celebrate Recovery meeting was held here last Tuesday night. It was a fantastic time. Mm-hmm. Both you and I were there, and it was really, really awesome, very encouraging to be a part of that. That is happening every Tuesday evening here at church at 6 p.m., and I really do want to encourage anyone who can, anyone who will, come out, be a part of that. It's a really, really awesome time and experience, and tell your friends. That's one of the things that this is a need in our area. It's a big need in our area, so word of mouth is still the best way to communicate information. So let people know that that is going on. Celebrate Recovery Tuesday evenings here at 6 p.m.
And another thing that we started at the start of this month is the 40 plus one thing that we've been doing, where we're encouraging everybody to take 30 minutes a day and pray for our town, for our nation, for our church, for our friends and our families, and just to really emphasize that focus of prayer in our community. And the plus one being having one gospel conversation a day. And that's a challenge for everybody. And even for us, we work in a church, and that's still a challenge. So we really encourage you, if you haven't started doing that, that's okay, dive in on it now. And it's been really a cool program that we've been doing, and we encourage you to hop in on that.
We say this most every week right before my message, but I do want to say again, thank you for your continued faithfulness in your giving you're giving to the church, but you're giving to God's kingdom. And I thank you for being faithful in that. One area that we've talked about a couple times and I want to bring back to your attention is our faith promise. We do a faith promise each year at church, and that is what we use to help support missionaries, not only here locally, here nationally, but all around the world as well. And that faith promise account, the monies in that account is getting low. It is low. It's not getting low. It is low. So I want to encourage you that if you've committed to giving to that, I ask that if you can, I know that there are some of us that that times have been tough through this COVID-19 with loss of employment, pauses in employment. But if you can, please give to that. And if you haven't pledged, please pray about that and consider giving to our faith promise, because our missionaries that we support, they're feeling the effects of it in some ways, maybe even more than what we are, probably in a lot of ways more than what we are. So just prayerfully consider that.
So we're about ready to hop into the service in a couple of minutes. So this morning we're starting a new series called Redeemer. So why don't you tell us a little bit about what we're diving into today?
Yeah, today we're looking at Redeemer. We're looking at not only why Jesus needed to come to be, that he came to be our Redeemer, but why he needed to come. So today we are looking at the fall. We're going all the way back to the beginning of the Bible, to the book of Genesis, chapters 1 through 3. Now, I'm not going to be reading all of chapters 1 through 3, but we're going to look at the fall of man and why we need Jesus as our Redeemer.
Awesome. Well, let's hop in, and we're going to watch this bumper video just before we dive into service to join Kennedy and the worship team.
Our Redeemer speaks. Named God of the Angel Armies, the Holy of Israel.
They remembered that God was their rock, that God Most High was their Redeemer.
He paid the ransom for his people. He ordered his covenant kept forever. He's so personal and holy, worthy of our respect.
He has delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins.
Because of the sacrifice of the Messiah, his blood poured out on the altar of the cross, we're a free people, free of penalties and punishments chalked up by all our misdeeds. And not just barely free either, abundantly free.
And the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing."